A lot of people want to know what's next for Virgil Ortiz. He's 18-0, 18 knockouts. He's one of the brightest young stars in the world of boxing. He's just a beast. Well, the WBO, this is their listing for the top 10. Virgil Ortiz, number one. Jerron Ennis, two. Terence Crawford, of course, the champion. Michael McKinson, three. Sandor Martin, four. David Avanesian, five. Kubratilo, six. Luis Crocker, seven. Imante Stanionis, eight. Keita Obara, 9. Chris Algieri, 10. Conor Benn, 11. Obviously, these rankings have not been updated in a moment because Conor Benn beat Chris Algieri, so Algieri can't be in front of him. And Kubratilo just lost, so he should be down lower on the list. Kubratilo last year was supposed to fight Sergey Lipinets, but he had visa issues, and that would have been for a world title. And I'm sure Sergey would have beaten him. So we would have had this whole listing different. But right now, so the big announcement, Virgil Ortiz looks like he's struck a deal to fight Michael McKinson of the UK, who's number three. Jerron Ennis, number two. Crawford, number one. So maybe Ennis and Crawford could fight. And the winner could fight the fight that was just announced yesterday by the WBA. This is the WBO between Errol Spence and Ordenis Ugas. Now, all these guys are great fighters. Terence Crawford, a great fighter. Virgil Ortiz, a great fighter. Jerron Ennis, a great fighter. Michael McKinson, a great fighter. Obviously, if he's ranked this high, he has to be legit. So, we'll keep you guys posted. But right now, that's big news. Virgil Ortiz getting closer and closer to being the mandatory for Terence Crawford. So, stay tuned. FaceNewsReporting.com. I'm Melly Secback reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter at Secback. You can follow me on Instagram at Ellie Secback. I'm Ellie Secback reporting. But ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Secback reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Secback reporting.